Lisa. Time for some Canadian Canoes! With our new Canadian Canoes music that makes me want to talk about news.
I feel like you've been waiting for this since we started.
I just like this song a lot.
I know you do.
This is one that during our decision-making process, there was really no question on this one. Once I played it through a couple times, this one is just, I just like this song a lot. All right, so let's get into it. I got a few stories here. Some of these, I think I'm going to start sharing things more on the Facebook page, if you're cool with that, like Facebook and Twitter, because some of these are fun stories, but things that are not great on an audio podcast, because it's mainly pictures or video and stuff like that, that on an audio podcast, you're not going to be able to see all those. So I might start doing that more. So send us an email, podcast@lisathearnitsa.com, if you want to see these things, because I always try to put them in the show notes so you can see them there. I don't know how many people actually go to the website to see and
not
read
that you're putting
stories.
Me on the spot or anything right now.
I'm just going to do it. You have no choice, Lisa. I'm taking over the Facebook page and Twitter and everything else.
All right. You can take over Twitter. I don't know how to work the Twitter machine. I can't figure it out. I don't know. I don't understand it.
You just say things as long as you use less than, 280 characters now?
Yeah, I get confused about it.
So the first story, this one, I don't know why this came up now. This one's from May of 2017. But apparently last year, I don't know a lot about fashion and things that are cool and trends and things like that. So I don't know if this will still be cool in 2018. But apparently over the summer of 2017, llamas are the furriest new wedding trend.
Too bad we didn't get married, 11 years later?
We can still get llamas. That's not a problem. When it comes to wedding trends, you never can tell what fad is going to pop up next. And that's what I just said. This may not be a thing by the time wedding season 2018 comes around. But we'll still go through it because even if it's not, it would be fun to do. So when llamas started RSVPing to wedding receptions, we can't say we were totally shocked. Instead of a show-stopping feature wall or a decked-out photo booth, all you need now are llamas or alpacas for unique furry photo ops. And so there's some fun pictures of people getting married, and they're there with their alpacas and the llamas have flower wreaths around their necks. But definitely, make sure to check with your venue so they can prepare you for four-legged guests. Also, always let your photographer know when you have big woolly photo shoot planned. I imagine, I don't know why the photographer would necessarily need to know that. I don't think it's going to change how they.
I think it's good if you're paying them a lot of money, and so I think just let them know all about everything. And
well, it's unusual, I guess. So yes. I guess that makes sense.
I'm guessing it's not normal for people to show up at their wedding with a llama. Except it is a trend.
Again, it was apparently a trend last year. So whether or not it's still a trend, it's hard to say. But I guess it's a trend as long as you want it to be a trend. So as long as people want to do it,
whether or not people say it's cool or not, you just do it. We could have had an alpaca ring bearer.
That would be something.
We should get married again.
I don't think it works that way.
Oh.
I think you kind of you do that once and that's it. That's the end. That's all you need.
That's the end. It's all over.
It's all over. There's nothing left after that. Then you've done it all.
Oh, that was in Japan.
Yeah, once again, it's a trend, Lisa.
So it's
everybody
not like,
likes it.
It's not like just a crazy bunch of people here in the States. It's you can rent them.
Well, yeah, you're not going to buy an alpaca for one day and then take it to the Humane Society or something.
Well, people have their dogs as ring bearers.
Sure. You could do that.
But I wouldn't rent a dog to be my ring bearer. That would be...
Yeah.
I would want my alpaca to be my ring bearer, not some random...
If you had an alpaca, you probably would. However, most people don't.
No, they don't.
So then you get your own. Next story I thought was a lot of fun. So in this one, it's about a doctor or someone going through doctor school, whatever you call doctor school. That'd be class.
Medical school?
More memorable with knitted eyeballs and organs. So Daniel Lamb learned to knit in eighth grade to impress a girl. Though the tactic didn't work, he kept at it with the knitting needles, and it's played an important role in his life in ways he likely didn't imagine back then. As a first-year student at the University of Chicago Pritzker School of Medicine, Lamb said he struggled to understand the anatomy of the eye. It's something that I couldn't learn even though it's explained in a book, and I drew models, but I couldn't get my head around it. I need something physical to imagine, he said. I learned it, and I passed the class. So he's now...
That's a lot of eye cord.
It's an eye cord, Elisa. On an eyeball, it's an eye cord. So he's now a teaching assistant for a human anatomy class. And when we were learning to, and we were getting to the eye part, I remembered how hard it was for me, he said. Rote memorization works, but it's not the easiest process. So I wanted to try and find a better way. And to me, I don't want a doctor who is just memorizing things to pass a test and just to get through it. I want somebody who is going to be able to know for the long term, all these different physiology and different parts of the body. So basically what this guy did was he went and he knitted himself an eyeball. He knitted all the muscles that control the eye and the optical nerve that goes back to the brain. And he took that in, was able to present it to the class and help them learn all the things. So he's done all kinds of knitting since then. It says, in addition to his medical creations, he's made hats, scarves, socks, blankets, gloves, miniature cats and ostriches. And he shares his creation. He's got a website called Masculinity, K-N-I-T-Y. It's clever. Each day he tries to knit for about an hour, mostly while watching TV. I think it's a good thing and an asset for me, Lamb said. Medicine is very concrete and scientific in nature, and I think in medicine that kind of mindset is encouraged, but creativity is less so. So knitting is my creative outlet.
Well, and I would think too, presenting it in a different way, in a different format, it might make it easier for other people to remember too. Because I mean, sure. I'm sure you could find like a model of an eyeball.
Yeah.
And you know, something like that. But
but this is something that they've probably never seen before. And you're gonna see that. Mm-hmm. Like, wow, that's different and unusual. And mm-hmm. he said that let him kind of play like when you pull the muscles on the eye, it makes the eye move in the way it's supposed to. And so that kind of helps him learn the I guess physiology and function.
I would
of
think
the various
that there's
muscles.
A model for that though, wouldn't you think?
Yeah, well you would think so, but I think this is more fun.
It's more fun, yes.
Yeah, it's more personal and it's gonna stand out and stick in people's brains because it is unusual and unique and something you don't normally get to see.
Well, and I remember stuff from my American history teacher when I think I was in eighth grade. He used to teach things in a very like offbeat kind of way and just different. And I still remember stuff from that. And that was like, you know, 10 years ago, 20 years ago.
About that. Or so.
30 years
approximately.
Ago. A few years ago. That was a few years ago.
Not much more than a few.
Yeah.
So very interesting story. Again, a fun slideshow. I will share that on in the show notes, as always. And finally...
And apparently on the Facebook page, too.
And the Facebook page, because that's where you share things. And I don't know this word. Knitting plastic is at Wifalas in Peru. Wifalas. W-I-P-H-A-L-A-S. My Spanish is not strong. But this, again, is one of those that probably plays better if you go through the story. There's a nice video that goes through it. But basically, this is done through an artist who made a big flag, I guess is what you would call it, made out of plastic. Basically went to kind of a landfill in a garbage area and got all these plastic bags because for a long time, of course, in Peru, I guess everywhere, but it didn't catch on until later in Peru, that you'd have the disposable throwaway shopping bags that everybody uses at all the grocery stores and everywhere else. So there, it wasn't an issue for a long time, but then of course, as this caught on throughout the country, they all end up in landfills. So he went out, he started picking up all these different bags of various different colors. He would wash them and clean them and cut them into strips and then use that to knit various articles. And it talks about, there's a big flag that's kind of a blanket that's on display at, I think it's an airport is where that's actually on display, but it's an interesting art installation where it kind of goes to talk about the history, I guess, of Peru. So it makes a connection between the past and the present where we've got kind of this new plastic bag thing that's kind of taking over and choking out nature and whatever, but also kind of connects it to the old-timey things. And some of the ladies that knit like little dolls and things like that. Mm-hmm. So instead of knitting them out of yarn, they're knitting them out of the plastic and doing some really neat things with that. So, you know.
Because they're going to be here forever, too.
And they're going to be around for a long time.
Yeah.
Yeah. So very cool. Again, so I will, I'll share this.
And it's pretty.
And it looks really cool. Yeah, and this thing is huge. I mean, the blank that he did is probably 20 feet long. Probably, what, 20 by 10? Something like that. It's a huge, huge blanket. And that is the... Oh, and this one too, but I'll share this on the Facebook page. Apparently the dodo, so if you don't follow...
Oh, I want a donkey!
If you don't follow the dodo on Facebook, you definitely should do that because it's pretty much the best page on Facebook because it's all about animals. Sometimes it's sad because, you know, there are sad things that happen with the animals, but most of the time they're fun. This one's just about a animal rescue. It was a donkey that was rescued. And I picked this one because I know Elisa likes donkeys, but also because at some point in this video, the donkey's wearing a scarf. Actually, she's wearing the scarf right now. There he is.
Aww.
So he's got the scarf wrapped around his neck and his head. It's super funny, but it's a fun story. I guess it doesn't start out very fun. It talks about how 5 years ago, this donkey was rescued by this woman because he had a rough time at the farm where he was. So she brought him home. She has apparently some kind of a sanctuary, and now he kind of is in control of who's cool and who's not and who gets in and who doesn't. But it's a very cool donkey.
He is. See, look at him, Mike. We need a donkey.
He's got the donkey's heads are huge.
Donkeys are adorable.
It's pretty cute.
Yeah.
And he likes muffins. So he's eating muffins. And there's another one eating muffins. So this one's already on Facebook, so it'll be easy to share. But apparently the dodo has a thing called party animals, which is all like celebrations of rescues and things like that. So probably another page on Facebook that I need to follow because it's just too much fun and too cute and very cool.
He is adorable.
Yeah. He's very fuzzy. He's got like goat eyes. I didn't know donkeys had goat eyes.
Donkeys have donkey eyes.
Oh, donkey eyes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
God, their heads are huge.
Mm.
He looks
They're pack animals. They're hardworking animals. They are not petite little things. They're rugged.
All right. So I think at this point we're probably at a spot where we can wrap it up and bind off, weaving our ends and all that kind of stuff, huh?
Yeah, can we get a donkey?